Hello, Brentwood High School. I'm Sam Dillard.
And I'm Cameron Johanches. Here's what's making news.
This past Thursday, choir partnered with drama to create a Disney-filled night. The choir sang everything from A Whole New World to Wish Upon a Star. And drama did everything from Disney 365 to Kim Possible. Here's Don Nieman with more on the event.
Last Thursday, the choir performed classic Disney songs for their fall performance. Drama continued to perform alongside them doing Disney-themed skits. Choir director Natalie Pat reflects on the choir performance and why she chose a Disney theme.
So last year we went to New York and it was this great experience. We worked so hard and I did a survey at the end of the year and students told me they wanted to go and just do something different. And the overwhelming majority response was Disney. So I decided to run with it. And so we're going to Disney in January. And so I decided to do a fall concert of all Disney favorites. It went really well. I've never done a concert in less amount of time. And so the students worked really hard. They did some difficult music, and I was very pleased and excited about it.
Julia Miracle's an advanced woman, and they were excited to perform A Wish Upon a Star. She was happy to explain about the experience and the feel of Disney.
I really liked singing When You Wish Upon a Star. It's a really pretty song, and it was fun singing it. I really like Disney because it's like it makes you feel nostalgic and like makes you think of your childhood, and it was really good.
The choir kids had a wonderful time showcasing these songs and feeling the magic of Disney. Don Nieman, WBHS 9.
Some Brentwood High School students will get to vote for the very first time next year. Williamson County election officials registered more than 100 Brentwood students to vote last week. Juniors and seniors who turned 18 before November 6th were eligible to register. If you missed out, you can still register at the Williamson County Administrative Building in Franklin. Just bring your driver's license, passport, or a government ID card. You'll also need your social security number.
Williamson County students continue to outperform students from across Tennessee. The projected ACT score for the county hit a record high of 25.2. That's up 0.6 of a point from last year. 8 out of 10 WCS students scored at least a 21, making them eligible for scholarships. The graduating class of 2017 earned $170 million in scholarship money. ACT scores from individual high schools aren't expected until next month.
Still to come,
a free ACT and a story on Brentwood Volleyball's Logan Eggleston.
Once again, BHS is sponsoring Career Shadow Day for seniors. This day gives our seniors the opportunity to spend the day with an area business person. Students shadow this individual at his or her place of work to learn about careers that are available. This year's Career Shadow Day will take place Wednesday, October 25th, and students are required to stay a minimum of 4 hours with their mentors.
For the first time, the state of Tennessee is giving high school seniors one more shot at the ACT. Gavin Robb has more.
Brentwood High School seniors are getting another free try at the ACT. This is the first time a free ACT has been offered to high school seniors. I caught up with Jackson Wilhoit on what he thought about the whole experience.
The last ACT I took, I got a 32, and you know, getting another free one, I guess is necessary. If you want to get more scholarships, you take it again, and if you don't have the money, you know, having another free one is a good idea, but I mean, it's not too hard of a test, I don't think. Mostly it's just pacing yourself correctly and, you know, common sense. Well, I didn't know that there was going to be a second free one for seniors, so my mom already signed me up for another one, and, you know, we had to pay for it because it's a paid standardized test. I guess I would have rather had the, you know, been informed about the free one than them just come in right once we get to the beginning of this year and say you're taking another ACT for free.
Gavin Robb, WBHS 9.
Brentwood junior Logan Eggleston is the first volleyball player in Brentwood history to qualify for the United States under 18 team. Sports director Ryan Schumpert caught up with her on her month in South America.
Brentwood junior Logan Eggleston spent the month of August in Argentina playing for the United States under 18 volleyball team.
Last spring, I tried out in Nashville. There's like 50 girls at the tryout, and there were 30 tryouts across the whole country. And so they chose 20 girls to go to Colorado Springs in the summer to like have another tryout. And then they chose 12 from there, and we tried out for 3 weeks in Colorado. And then they chose 12, and then those 12 went straight to Brazil to play. And it was a lot of fun, the tryout was, because there's, you know, the 20 best girls in the whole country, so it was really competitive. And there's a lot of great coaches there just like helping us train. And it was really exciting because I made the team last year, and I was really hoping to make it again just because of how great the experience was last year. So it was really fun.
Logan, another fabulous player. I mean, just imagine, you know, she played on the USA under 18 national team. And she's amazing. Her physical attributes, her skill level, we have really missed her on the court.
The United States team couldn't bring home the gold medal, but still had a successful tournament.
We finished eighth, and we got third in pool play, so we went into gold, the gold bracket, after a crossover match. So we did pretty well, like based on, we only had like a month of training compared to the other teams that had been training for like the whole year. So we did really well in that sense, and we were a really young team, so it was fun. We did well.
Eggleston's focus now turns to Brentwood and helping the Bruins win their fifth straight state tournament.
Well, we obviously want to win state again, and without Garrett this year, we want to win for her because we know how bad she wants to be on the floor with us, and just like we did every other year, just you know, play one game at a time, and we'll get there, get to the state championship again.
Ryan Schumpert, WBHS 9 Sports.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Sam Dillard.
And I'm Cameron Johanges. See you next time on WBHS 9 News.